What's good, YouTube? With the Apple Watch becoming more and more popular and with new versions becoming cheaper and more accessible to the masses, more and more running enthusiasts are using the Apple Watch to track their runs. And while the native Apple's Activity app does offer some great tracking features, there's a few other solutions available on the market that offer several very compelling features that can't be ignored. These are, of course, the Nike Run Club app and the Strava app, two of the most popular running apps and fitness tracking apps available for the Apple Watch. So if you like running with your Apple Watch, in this video we'll be going over some of the design, features, and strengths and weaknesses of the Nike Run Club app and Strava, and let you decide which app is best for you and your needs as a runner. If you like this kind of content, leave a message down below. Don't forget to subscribe and also share your favorite stories about using each of these apps. So without further ado, let's get into the comparison between the Nike Run Club app and Strava for the Apple Watch. In terms of the user interface, both of these apps feature very refined, easy to read and easy to navigate interfaces that allow you to quickly start an exercise and or a run and allow you to easily, while in the middle of your run, track your stats. If color is something that is important to you, then the Nike Run Club, with its branding, does opt for this neon green colorway, whereas the Strava, with its own branding, does opt for a more orange colorway. In terms of the actual user interface, both apps are set up somewhat similarly, where you swipe left and right to access various menus on the app. The Nike Run Club app is a little bit more complex, as you have four swipeable menus. Here you can see your run history, start a new run, look through guided runs, and go through your options. Strava is a little bit more simple, as there's just two swipeable horizontal menus, one for your settings and one to start a new exercise. Both user interfaces are well designed and aesthetically pleasing, and you can use the Apple Watch dial to navigate through the various options you have on each menu. During your exercise, you'll notice that the on-display readout from both of the apps are somewhat similar, as it describes the duration of your run and your pace. Nike Run Club is notable for having a lot more information on your heads-up display while you're in the middle of an exercise. Both apps also feature very similar pause recording menus, allowing you to finish your given exercise or run, use the water eject feature on your Apple Watch, and also access your settings. The Nike Run Club pause menu is notable for being able to switch over to your music with a swipe right, which the Strava app does not have. So overall, the Nike Run Club does have a slight edge over the Strava app in terms of user interface. It has a little bit more options, and overall I found the Nike Run Club app to be much more aesthetically pleasing than the Strava app, even though the Strava design is no slouch in itself. Nike just has the animations, the sounds, and the typography down on its Apple Watch app. In terms of features, at their core, both apps are fitness tracking activity apps. They both fulfill the function of being able to track the duration, distance, and speed of your given exercises. Both apps can make use of the Apple Watch's onboard sensors to track your heart rate. And one thing that the Strava app does better than the Nike app is that it tracks the elevation of your runs as well. Sadly, all this great data is organized in a beautiful and easy to read way on Strava, but it's only available once you fire up your iPhone. You can't actually see your run history on the onboard Apple Watch Strava app. The Nike Run Club, on the other hand, has a separate menu on the Apple Watch that you can use to track your previous runs. Like the rest of the app, this feature is very easy to navigate, and the readouts from your run history are both pleasing aesthetically and laid out in a way that's easy to track and record your history. Another area where the feature set of these two apps differ is that Strava, of course, will offer the ability to track different types of exercises, like cycling, for example, whereas the Nike Run Club app is strictly for running. However, it does offer several options to track indoor and or outdoor running, and different options for speed as well as duration. It's safe to say that Strava is a multi-exercise fitness tracking app, whereas the Nike Run Club app is a running-centric tracking app that offers a lot more specialization and customization to track different types of runs. So if you're a runner and strictly only a runner, then the Nike Run Club app specialization towards running might be very attractive to you. However, this is not to say that the running tracking on the Strava is a slouch by any means. It's actually very polished, and the readouts that you actually get from the Strava iPhone or desktop app are comparable to those found in the Nike Run Club app. The social and community aspect of both of these apps is where they differ the most, and probably where you will make your decision in terms of which app best suits your fitness needs. Both the Nike Run Club app and Strava have been well received on their own merits and have enjoyed multiple years and generations of user-based growth and popularity. However, they have diverged in the respect that the Nike Run Club app is popular mostly as a running app, whereas Strava is more of a community-based fitness tracking platform. There is a community option with the Nike Run Club app if you hook it up to your iPhone, and you can choose between various Nike Run Clubs in specific cities. However, I found these to be mainly unpopulated, and I had difficulty finding a run club in my city. And I was very disappointed to see this, as it looks like the Nike Run Club app has the adequate infrastructure and design in order to be a thriving community, but it just doesn't seem to be there in the way that Strava does it. Strava, on the other hand, is a booming and bustling online social community with over 50 million users. And it's this huge online community that is one of Strava's biggest strengths and one of the most exciting aspects about using the Strava app. You'll likely be able to find a Strava club in your municipality, and you'll likely find that the Strava users are active and are listing their Strava segments on a given community. These segments and the map integration into the desktop and also iPhone app for the Strava is significant, as it adds an entirely new element to your fitness tracking and your runs that is largely absent on the Nike Run Club app. The Strava segment maps are both detailed and help people find the best running routes in their given city. Nike really doesn't have anything comparable to this. Their guided runs do help with certain aspects of runs, and the Nike Run Club guided run coaches do provide valuable motivation and insights and training during their narrated runs. But this quite simply just does not stack up with being able to compare your results with thousands upon thousands of other runners in your Strava community. What Strava has set up is just a bustling online social platform that allows you to get detailed statistics about specific run routes and how other runners are doing. It's really quite a treat to see just the amount of statistics and information that you can get from a specific segment on your Strava routes. The Strava maps and community portion really also helped me find some hidden gems in terms of running routes in my local community. So in terms of which is a better app for running, the question really is, what do you need from your running app? If you just need a straight up fitness tracker where you can track your runs really easily and quickly, then there's nothing really better in the App Store than the Nike Run Club. With its combination of excellent UI, great design, and simple approach, the Nike Run Club app allows you to, with a few quick swipes and a few taps, start tracking your runs in an easy to understand way. However, if you're looking for a more feature-rich experience where you can track multiple exercises and have a community that can motivate you and help you find the best routes for running and other exercises, then there's nothing else on the market like Strava. Both of these apps are very old, refined, and both have loyal followings in each of their respective communities. Indeed, the Nike Run Club has been around on several platforms, and experienced runners will likely know people or themselves will be people that have used the Nike Run Clubs over a period of years. Likewise, Strava started off big on the cycling and then segued over to running as well, and people have profiles on the Strava community boards that span hundreds and hundreds of runs and hundreds of segments. And the fact that both of these apps have gone through multiple generations of updates and iterations means that both do what they do quite exceptionally well. The fitness tracking features at its core on both the Nike Run Club and the Strava app are excellent, easy to use, and very well tuned. Both apps have reached that level of maturity where you don't need the iPhone with you in order to utilize the apps, and are both standalone on the Apple Watch. So if you're looking for basic run tracking, then either of these apps will certainly do the trick for you. If you're looking for easy to read statistics and a very polished running and fitness tracking experience, then you might want to opt for the Nike Run app. If you're looking for one of the largest social fitness communities available on the internet and a very well-developed mapping system for figuring out specific run routes, then Strava really is the best choice for you. So what do you think? Do you think these two well-known running apps are the best of the bunch? Leave a message down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Have a great run, and thanks for watching.